yaara ñi la domoro ka diate
boy janno sikes restaurant
be say nakko be ni na dimbal ni mba domoro kala janno
domoro seneata adiata topotoro fanan kendema bigge luntan during tamala abbe ka domoro ki janni adi manda wala de takawé bi jélé anim fanan ka fadi jang ikono fa e ka fa min nako pastry anim bakery iko fanan be kalel badde lomba conference lomba workshop lomba ye fo fenil lon dunya kono domoro betama nyilom international o tewda number 1
amanke ba domo la janda man
e sa domo jang is ataria
a wo mu ku bandi
sa na ko sa futandin
e oto sa na ko be mu CKS restaurant
ndaba non janna mu yat ni manje dorom bi jang
aban
CKS restaurant known for best quality food and customer satisfaction.
Owning your dream homes, EJ Investment is here for you. Secure our quality bungalows with 2, 3, or 4 bedrooms, or our story buildings, 3 or 4 to 5 bedrooms at very affordable prices with flexible payment plans at our Sanyang Sea View Estate, where you can enjoy the cool breeze with modern infrastructure such as taroots, covered drainage system, modern electrification with street lights, gated entrance with security posts, and social amenities such as gas station, shopping mall, medical clinic, park, schools, children daycare, and a lot more. Our dedicated team of professionals will keep the estate clean at all times, provide security and patrol team within the estate premises, install latest technologies such as CCTV, Wi-Fi, home network installation, solar panel, and power backup system. Also, check out for our additional home facilities and interior design service such as premium tiling, wall plaster, home landscape, fingerprint home lock, and a lot more. Visit our office at Senegambia Kololi Highway and get a free site visit tour, or contact us on 4464-838, WhatsApp us on 3259220, or you can visit our Facebook page or Instagram on EJ Investments. EJ Investments, we are first in properties.
Communication, connectivity is everything. We ensure that the links never sleep. Quantities and qualities, all in our data service, providing efficient, reliable voice and data service. We believe if you're not up to speed, then you're going backwards. Communications have to flow as fast as the speed of light. Whatever business you're in, having someone who understands your needs is critical. That is why we just don't offer you technology, we offer you solutions. Enjoy Gamcel's internet broadband anytime, anywhere. Your national operator, Gamcel, Yai Barom.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I would suggest we start with silent opening prayers. After opening prayers, we'll have Mohammed Senden give his remarks. Then we'll have Numa Sonko give remarks. Then Dr. Malanding Jaite would give remarks. Then from there, we'll have the signing of the contract between MAP and the Project Coordinating Committee, and a vote of thanks by Mohammed Jagana. And then there'll be a tour of the house led by the contractor, Mr. AB Guy. So can we have a silent prayer, please?
So thank you very much for coming and answering to our call of the Sandeng family and our assistors. And I thank you all for having to be with us, you know, throughout all of this journey. I mean, our assistors, Mohammed Jagana and MABB Construction and every other person that had donated from the point of the fundraising, I mean, to this point of starting the project and the signing of the project. I just want to outline a few things about this house, and that is to say it is going to house my siblings and of course myself and my mother, which makes it a very important initiative or a very important endeavor for me. So I would want to thank each and everyone that made it possible, I mean, for us to start building this house. I thank you all. I just want to outline also the importance of the GoFundMe and the donations that led, I mean, to the starting of this project. They are very important as they are geared towards giving a home to a family of 9 people, most of whom are school-going children below the ages of 20, let me say, minimum. So that makes it a very important endeavor, not only as a befitting tribute to the late Solo Sandeng, but also it shows the generosity of Gambians and the concern that Gambians have for their fellow Gambians. I wish to thank again every other person that donated and that shared those GoFundMe links that led to any other person that donated to have to donate to this GoFundMe, I mean the project. And we still want to call on more people to donate once it kicks off, because our funds as at now are not enough to exhaust the building of the project here. So we're actually launching this project today, I mean, with the great efforts of some great people who have been supporters of our family, and they had, you know, made everything possible to see us through all of this up to this position, and we want to thank them all. On behalf of my family, I want to say thank you to all of them, and also thank you to the general Gambian people that really saw the need to donate to this GoFundMe and make our dream of moving into our house after a couple of leases possible. So I want to take this opportunity one more time to say thank you to all of you and make it known that as we have started this project, the funds that we have acquired that is in our possession will not be able to complete, I mean, the building, and we will be very grateful that we have the more commitments coming in.
Assalamu alaikum. Mo kontana ni do ni mami aliake ja de dina dimbal be bal kontana ko kontanta baake kay ta dalla ko kontanta baake le ni ketam bulu sewo baleti do ni ku yakole mbara sewo telefona ni keta aliena galena korda laban na nyame loñe pour na korda laban solo sande le solo sande na dimbal ye sutura damento ketagne fenti mi yala kontano wartanka be duala molbe adembe mobe tentula be jayla mini keta mini bulo duñe koto kata faltolu mini yalon ko albakela abakante be duala albe fo ala se kera jama kal be oke ñing ko kontano ni aja wartanka kosbe dame tel birin so bantani mbita mel waso la ado waso amer na luaso ñu be expire la next 2 months la be expire so wo kamala wo kitambulu jahal ko balati no ni na dimbayal jaka tan wa kola no baake nde won tanu bari birin nata mohammed nata fagne ni kitam de ngoti tay tan dina ko ibe kordani mala le last monday wo wol se wota katu ngalon ko tumado nanni ku ya be falen na nyakairo la bal be kontona duala mobe ba falale al nimbar do ntalbe to fono la because man to tolbe lo Mr. Jagana ini la molbe me dual al be ala al sosi jangola al ni jama ni yalon ko gambe din kendo wara banko din kendol min yalon ko lote la banko e ke la dimbal nya fita albe lori wala ala ma ala al ju wassalam
A very good afternoon to everyone here and beyond. And of course, a very good morning to all those who live west of us, mainly in the United States and beyond, because this is a global effort. Gambian diaspora are everywhere, almost every country out there, we have a Gambian. And when, of course, the tragic events of 2016 occurred, the moment when Mr. Ibrahim Asolo Sandeng and team, knowing the dangers involved, knowing all the issues that were involved, decided to ask and come out and ask the world and the current, at the time, the dictatorship, to allow Gambians to freely express themselves through the ballot box as to who they want as their leader. You know, it was, and it has still, it can still be seen as perhaps the most important moment in our struggle to end the tyranny that had reigned in the Gambia for 22 years. So Mr. Solo Sandeng, unfortunately, you know, was grabbed in public and of course was never seen again alive. Of course, everybody knew then that he was murdered, but that did not stop the Gambian people from moving forward and making sure that we end those days forever. And you know, today most of us, in fact many of us today and almost all of Gambia, is celebrating that breath of fresh air, the liberty that we have seen, knowing fully well that those people like Ibrahim Sandeng and many others who lost their lives gave up not only their lives, but also the caring of their family and all the responsibilities that come with family men, so that we can enjoy this little freedom. You know, really raising these funds and making sure that we get to a moment where the family that he cared for so long and for so much could have a place they call home has become a responsibility as well as an obligation to us Gambians who are today enjoying the freedom that his death and many others' death really gave us. And the people both in the diaspora and within the country over the last 1 year, you know, contributed immensely. They did whatever they could in Dallases and dollars and pound sterlings and euros and everything that you can name, so that we can come together as a country to say thank you. We can come together as a country that can say, you know what, yes, Mr. Sandeng, you gave all you got, including your life, but we are here and we still care for you and for all those you care for. And really, this has been a very, yes, hard-fought battle and is still ongoing, because raising, you know, all the money that is needed to complete this house has been a challenge. We have so far raised 884,000 plus, almost 889,000 Dalasis. And when we approach good people in country, we got Mohamed Jagana, as well as Tough Global Foundation. They have come up and really decided to help us make sure that the hard-earned money that was raised in the diaspora as well as in country is put into good use, to make sure that the money is spent, every single dollar is spent on the building. And with their help, we were able to secure the contractor, MAA&B contractors. They are actually working in the background here. They are now ready to pick up to make sure that this building is completed in the coming months. We are also going to ask more people and ask all those who are previously contributed to dig deeper into their pockets and see whatever they can add to what we have already gotten, because even though we raised 800,000, almost 900,000 dollarses, it is clear that it will take more than 1.5 million to complete this building. So we are therefore asking every single Gambian wherever they may be, to help. It does not matter how many. If we all put $1 together today, a piece, you know, we should be able to meet that required. So it is essential that we tell our folks, and of course, some of you here, to extend the message further, in order for us to be able to come back in April and see the Sandem family in their rightful place. This is the place that Mr. Solo Sandem acquired for himself, and he started the process. He just could not do it today because he is not alive. And certainly he did not die throwing himself in the sky or jumping off that airplane, no. He did it for what was right, for what many of us could not do at the time, and that is to stand out there and say to the world, can you ask this dictator to allow us free and fair election? I mean, that was a very simple request by someone holding a placard on the side of a street, and he was not doing it throwing stones or running around and yelling and screaming, no. And for someone to pick him up and beat him to death certainly is not what Gambians are about. It has never been a Gambian thing to do that. And, you know, we want to prove that it is not. That one was an aberration. That one was something that was that Gambians don't do. This is what Gambians do. We help each other to build their lives. And certainly we want to help this family at least to have a semblance of a family, which is what? A home. You know, and that's really where we are today. And I thank you all once again for coming, taking all the time. It has been a very difficult day for some of you to move from one program to another. But indeed, it is an honorable thing. And I certainly, you know, see myself as only a representative of the many, many, many tens of hundreds of people who have donated, you know, here and there to come together. And we should, no doubt, feel comfortable that the money that is raised is going to be well spent. And it's definitely our desire to make sure that the Sandem family move into their home in April. You know, and that is really unfortunate month also, because that month will be the very much, you know, the month that Mr. Sandem lost his life standing up for the Gambia. So these are serious symbolic days and symbolic months, but we want everyone to help raise the extra funds that is needed. And, you know, I cannot say that more, but it's definitely something that we need. We need everyone's support to make this. And once again, I thank all the partners, especially, you know, TAF Global Foundation, and also Mr. Mohamed Jagana, you know, JFIN, because they are definitely, you know, busy people. They are involving a lot of things, but they have taken up all the time and all the energy to make sure that we get the right contractor and we also get the right direction. And, you know, certainly they are doing their best to help, you know, but certainly we want to reach out to everyone once again, you know, to see that this honorable job of making sure that the Sandens have a place called home is realized. And I thank you all.
Held the ultimate dream of one day building a dream home for his young family and lovely wife. Unfortunately, Solo could not realize that wonderful dream of his due to ultimate sacrifice paid when he stood up for a bigger dream of a better Gambia. Today we stand on the very ground on which Solo toiled and sweated as he sought to provide a dream home for his family. Solo made the ultimate sacrifice for our nation. He gave his life so that you and I can live in a better Gambia. Not only does he deserve to be remembered, but we all owe it to him to keep alive his dream of bringing fruition of some of his dreams, finishing this home and moving his family in here. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the team that conceived this idea, which was initially initiated to me by Momodou B. Kurbali, but among them was Dr. Malanding Jaite, our Tukulor C, Anna Jaite, and a lot more that we could not name all. I was asked by Momodou B. Kurbali if I would volunteer my time to help coordinate the local efforts to implement the project, and asked Mustafa Njai of TAF Global to help build the house. I, of course, accepted, and TAF's response when I called him made me feel that I made the right choice. When I approached him as director, he said, as a matter of fact, we all owe it to Solo Sandeng. And without flinching, he was on board and gave his full support through the TAF Africa Foundation. Through support from the TAF Africa Foundation, which is represented here by Usainu Sosa today, we managed to identify the contractor, Mr. Guy of MAP Architecture and Construction, to build Solo's dream home. Mr. Guy, we thank you for taking up this meaningful and historic task. To all the donors and supporters, we say thank you. We also appreciate all who are here this afternoon to lend your support to this noble project. By just attending this simple ceremony, and to the media especially, by reaching out and sharing our message, we say thank you for the headlines and reports that we expect to hear or realize in the coming days to be able to raise the funding to be able to finish this house. The dream of a man who laid down his life so that we can enjoy a better Gambia for all. I thank you all and God bless you. That's end of the formal part of the press briefing. So now I think we'll just hold one of the contracts with Nyuma, MAP and the family. We'll do photo opportunities. Then Mr. Guy will take you around the house and explain to you the layout and that stuff.
Family and everybody that's involved in this noble project, just welcoming you guys in the for the first time on site. Actually, the plot size, let me start with the plot size, a huge land though, which is 3,080 square meters, and you have the floor area of the building to is 280 square meters with four bedroom bungalow house. But we do, as you have already heard, we are still short on cash, so we shrink the floor area of the building from 280 to 150 meter square. So I will welcome you guys so we can do the tour. As you can see, that's the entrance. My guys are walking. As you can see, we've started the backfilling. So the target, as has been mentioned already, it's end of March that we're supposed to complete the job. Though we are tight on schedule, but we will finish it. We will finish it because the work is. The duration of the contract is 2 months. Yes. So by end of March, I should be wrapping up, and 1st of April, do the handing over to the committee and the family, inshallah. So as you can see, we started with the block work. The structure has been here for a very long time. Most of the walls were dilapidated, and we had some structural failure. So we have to knock most of the walls down and then redo the configuration. So now, rather than having the four bedroom, we've managed to have the dining and kitchen for now. And hopefully if the budget increases, we'll increase obviously the floor area of the building. So as you can see, work is going on once again. So please watch your steps. So as you can, that'll be the kitchen area. These are some of my workers. So here's the toilet. Going to be the shared toilet and one bedroom. There's the other two bedrooms located on this side here with the shared toilet. And here you have the corridor. Moving around, so you have a circulation. Watch your steps, please. And here's the master bedroom with this toilet. Yes. So for now, with the amount we've got so far, we're going to close up the house from this point. As you can see, the two trenches. So as of Now, this part of the building, it's not included because the budget we have so far cannot cover it up. So that's why we shrink the floor area to 150 square meters rather than the 280 square meters. But hopefully, by time goes on, we're hoping Gambians will come forward and then fulfill their pledges so that we can go ahead and just complete the whole structure, one, so that the family can live in, come and live in comfortably without worrying about space or anything like that.
Do you live abroad and want to build your dream home in the Gambia without risking your funds and family ties? Do you want a household name that is trustworthy and efficient? A name that will continue to give you updates on the project from the beginning to the very end with videos and pictures? If your answer is yes, then worry no more. Boss Construction and Asset Management is here for you. If you live outside the Gambia and want to build your dream home, then this is ideal for you. Just reach out to Boss Construction and let's start building the dream home into a reality. With Boss Construction, the difference is clear. We give you value for money. Some of our services include the following: construction management, building equipment rentals, rent management, purchase and leasing, asset management, and many more. For more information, please contact 282-4945. Better still, send us an email, bossgambia@gmail.com, or you can also visit our website on www.bossgambia.com. Boss Construction, a name you can trust. Boss Construction and Asset Management, keeping families together.
Na?
I'm going
to
tell
you about myself. You don't know. Yeah. No man or some man, not to lose some. Similar.
No.
Yalla ñu mëno wara demé jona bureau ngay taawlat nga ta ko do kama demé man façon fula wala bijé kilo talul tabajé kilo moone lul tabajé hané duulino bijé ni taalé ko do kama ni def ko do lé ci ko do taa inaita na diaté fune ci manou lu sanjani tulon ni hané ñi fo ngoñi alkaw mé do amul kaw mé fo kan di ring lewé ñu leminato nga bon dijé
yuna
la ka ñu bé sama na yaaje
Faro company miñu indil bébé Mariam moñu indil amitamate
ay sé sa ben ci xoxuna
amitamate dé mo ci jaar
amitamate
waaw amitamate
moko xoxal ni ciim
waaw
bis ni kité dé na la amitamate
ko xanna
domi dé amitamate la ci yoni ko bëgg na moy def bépp marché bo duga bitik supermarket table bépp fo duga ci biir réew bi nga am amitamate.
Thank you.